strategy module 2 on digital branding. So in this module, we will understand the importance of digital branding and what other ways to digitally brand our website, our social media pages, and our overall strategy of digital branding. So starting with the name of our brand. So if you have finalized the name of your brand, or if you are in the process of still finding a name, it is very important to understand a few basics about your branding. So if you're still confused of how to find a brand name, or if you have a few names in your mind, the first step you should go and check is whether the domain name is available for that brand name. So to check the domain name availability, so there are many websites that you can you will find online. To name a few examples are GoDaddy, Namecheap, and so on. And on if you go on that website, there will be a section wherein you can type your name, and when you search that name, the website will help you to know that whether this domain name that you're looking for is available or not. So it is very important to evaluate your brand name subject to the domain name availability. So like in traditional businesses, it was important to understand whether the trademark is available for that name or not, which is also important in an online business. But in an online business, along with trademark, it is also important to understand whether the domain name is available or not. So please go check the domain name availability for the brand name that you want to start with. So again, if your name is very common and the domain name is not available, you can always look forward to add a prefix or suffix to your brand name, and then you can finalize a domain name. And if you need any help to if you're confused with the name, or maybe if you just have an ideation of the name, and if you want more ideas on the name, so there are also many websites which can help you on the name ideation as well, which can help you to finalize a name. So one of the website I have listed down here, so that's called as biznamewiz.com. So on the PPT also you can have a look, and you can go on this website. It can and there might be many other websites also similar to this. You can explore these websites if you need a help even to finalize the name. Then after the domain name is being finalized, the next part is to have to create a Facebook social media pages. So on social media pages, like it is the Facebook page, Instagram page, Twitter, then and so on. So the primary sources, or the I would say a must do in terms of name, is a domain name, the social media page names, so that is Facebook and Instagram. So this is one thing. These are the three things that you should start with immediately, and then you can start with your YouTube channel, the Twitter, Pinterest, and so on. Now when you're finalizing a domain name, when you go to these websites to search for a domain name, so you will find extensions like .com, .net, .in, .biz. So what is the meaning of these extensions? So .com is the most commonly used extension across the globe, which means it is an commercial organization, and it is always preferred to have a .com domain name. So first preference you should give to a .com domain name. If you are not getting a .com domain name in the name that you would be looking for, then the second preference you should give to a country specific domain name. So that is .in, .uk, .uae, .ca, .usa. So in the country where you want to operate your online business, the primary country from where you want to operate it, then that is the domain name that you can secondly opt for. And there are a few domain names which depends on your business model. Like for example, .net, so .net. So this is, .net is moreover for the IT companies. Then .biz is about business, any business. Then .gov is reserved only for government websites. .edu's is again reserved only for educational institutions. So again, .edu and .gov are not publicly available to register. So .com and country specific domain names is where you should be looking for, and first preference should always be given to a .com, because with a .com extension there also comes a brand identity, there comes a brand trust. So if you have a .com, so today if you are maybe you will start with a specific region within your country, or you may start selling across your country, and tomorrow if you want to go global, so again in global target market, .com is an extension which will be accepted readily. So .com is where I would advise to give a first preference. Now let us understand that what do we mean by digital branding. So and I will also explain a few examples that how are the brands creating this digital branding presence across their different channels. So here is an example of a retail organization which is called Tanishq, and here I've added a few snapshots of their website, of their social media pages like Twitter and Facebook. So if you see their website and social media pages, you will find a uniformity in it. So you will find the background that they've used on the banners is the same. Then if you see the taglines that they've used, so what is the latest trend, or maybe what is the latest offer, or maybe what is the what is that the tagline of the brand. So if you visit their website or if you visit their social media pages, you will find a uniformity. So if you see on this Twitter account as well as on their YouTube account, the banner image is the same. So the content used is the same. Again, when we talk about your social media pages, so if you see this the section where the thumbnail section, it is important to always have your logo in the thumbnail section. So you should not update maybe the product or maybe any other photo, but then it should always your logo should be there in the thumbnail. So again, if you see their social media pages like Facebook, in the thumbnail they have their logo. In Twitter they have their logo. Even on the YouTube channel, in the thumbnail they have their logo. So this uniformity should be maintained. And if you see the theme and the color, so the colors being maintained across all the channels is also the same, the brand color. So it's not that maybe on Twitter they are using green color, on Facebook they are using blue color, and maybe if you go to their website you will find something in black color. No, so there is always a uniformity that they maintain across all the social on all the channels where they are present. And if you see the extension of Tanishq, so their website is tanishq.co.in. So this is also an extension which can be used. So maybe tanishq.com was not available, so they have taken this extension. Then their Facebook extension, so again it's facebook.com/tanishq. And if you see that Twitter extension, it's different than Facebook extension. Here it says Tanishq Jewelry. So on Twitter, they might not have got Twitter/Tanishq. So that is why they've added a suffix to it. So that is Tanishq Jewelry. So even on similar lines, you can either have a prefix or maybe a suffix to your brand name if you're not able to find it with your name, that particular extension. So these are the ways, you know, you need to adopt when it comes to the extension of your names and the brand presence across different channels. So this was an example of a retail brand. Going forward, I will be giving you an example also of a manufacturing company. So their business model is B2B. Previously, the example that we saw was a B2C business model. So in this B2B business model, so here I'm giving an example of a manufacturing company called Anand Group. So here I've given you a snapshot of their YouTube page, This is their Twitter page, and this is a snapshot of their website. So if you go to these, again, the social media pages, you will see again in the thumbnail, they have their logo. And the wallpaper, if you see on the Twitter, at the back end, they have a wallpaper. So at the wallpaper, they have shown different units, photos of their different units. And even if you go to their website, there is a beautiful video that is being playing on that is being played on their website. And again, on their YouTube channel, they have a very good video. So the objective that they are achieving over here is, so if anybody is coming to their social media channels, they are giving a big picture about their company. So this is a big company, but then if anybody is coming to their social media pages, so without any communication, how do we tell our users or our visitors that yes, we are a big company? So that is what they have been, they have tried to achieve this objective. So this is how they are digitally building their brand. So anybody is coming to any of their channels, they are able to communicate that through pictures, through videos, that yes, we are a big company and you can have trust in us. Another example, this is an architecture firm. Again, their business model is B2B. And here I've given a snapshot of their Twitter page. So this is a snapshot of their YouTube channel, and this is a snapshot of their website. So again, if you see you'll find the logo in the thumbnail. You will find beautiful wallpapers when you land on their different channels. And again, the wallpapers, if you see, it is saying that yes, we do, we are into architecture and we do it for commercial spaces. So if you see the photos, so here again, this is a photo which has a very beautiful landscape, but it is a commercial office. So again, here on their website, they have a photo of a commercial office. On their Twitter also, they have a photo interior of a commercial office. So it will communicate that we are an architecture brand and we work for designing of commercial spaces. So when you visit their website or maybe any of their social media channels, this communication is very loud and clear. And again, if you see the uniformity in terms of colors, it's the same. So they have maintained a theme of black, white and yellow. So these are the three major colors that is being used across all their channels. So another example of an IT service company. So this is an example of a company called Tata Consultancy Services. So here I have a snapshot again of their YouTube channel, of their Twitter page and their website. So again, if you go to their social media channels, again in the thumbnail, you will only find the logo. And again, when we talk about logo, there is a consistency. So there is a white background and their logo is blue color. Now here in this example, now they are offering a new service. So this service is called Secure Borderless Workspaces. Now they want to promote this new service. So if you go to their Twitter page and their other social media pages, they are using this banner. So they are using the same banner to promote this new service. So this is also a way to communicate to your visitors if you have any new service or maybe new products that you have come up with, and you can portray those services on all your social media platforms, and so that it is being communicated to your visitors also that okay, this is a new service that or maybe an offering that you have come up with.